Hi, Dr. Courtney, Jesus Professor here. And in this episode of Jesus 101, we're talking about how conservatives and Christians are complicit in child pornography. Child porn is defined as sexualized pictures of naked people under 18, minor children. It is well established that this perversion leads to the sex trafficking of children. Child porn ignites lustful passions toward minor children, and these lustful passions desire sex with children, and lacking that, to be inflamed with more and more child porn. These demands create a market, and since the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil, these dark markets motivate evil people to do all kinds of evil to obtain more and more child porn and minor children themselves to traffic to satisfy this dark market. It is shameful to even mention what the disobedient do in secret. It's even more shameful the ways that people and institutions that purport to follow Jesus are contributing to this problem by being complicit in child porn production and distribution through their tacit approval.
In your name I call the light to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me.
The sending and receiving of nude sexual pictures in sexting is the distribution of pornography. If the subject is a minor, then it is the crime of possession or distribution of child pornography. Society is complicit in that it's common today that the perpetrators usually only receive consequences if they're adults. If the perpetrator is a minor teenager, especially a teen close in age to the victims depicted in the images, they usually don't receive any disciplinary or criminal consequences. Teens and preteens seldom receive consequences for making and distributing child porn of themselves or of others close in age. The sending and receiving of sex text messages with sexual nudes often attached is ubiquitous in middle and high schools today. Depending on the study, between 10% and 50% of teen cell phones have these nudes on them from sexting. In other words, between 10% and 50% of cell phones in middle and high schools contain child pornography. But when you ask the administrators of your local Christian school or church youth group how many students have received disciplinary consequences for possession and distribution of this child porn in the last year, odds are pretty good that the number will be very low, often even zero. Likewise, one can also compare the frequency of criminal consequences being brought for this child pornography from purportedly conservative law enforcement agencies and prosecutors, usually Christian teachers, youth group leaders, and even many parents turn a blind eye to this child pornography, preferring not to stir up trouble. Now, I'm not saying that minor teens need to always be widely prosecuted for this crime. Confiscation and destruction of the pornography and the electronic devices would be a good start, along with notification of parents of these minor children every single time. And at some point, especially for teens who are repeatedly soliciting and distributing child pornography, expulsion from school and notification of legal authorities makes sense. Here's why. Complicity and tacit approval has the effect of training the hearts and consciences of the teens that porn, including the child porn that they're soliciting, creating, and sharing, is okay. These teens reach adulthood with their consciences seared as with a hot iron. The rules on the books are not taken seriously. Now, imagine a speed limit that was almost never enforced for drivers under 18. Or imagine a drug law that was never enforced for users under 18, or even for drug makers or distributors under 18. The effect of such lax enforcement would be a lot more teens reaching adulthood with no compunction against such behaviors. If you're a parent who has been complicit relating to porn on the phones of your children or their friends, you need to repent and express your repentance through both words and a change in action. If you're a school admin, teacher, or youth group leader, your path to repentance needs to include actions that live up to the expectations set forth in the applicable handbooks and standards. It also includes letting parents know every time that their minor child is discovered to be involved with pornography. We should all have a zero tolerance policy toward pornography as it relates to children. It's notable that in the months I've been talking about this, not a single Christian or leader has told me that they and their institution is very careful to always loop parents in when minor teens are discovered making, distributing, or possessing child pornography. Instead, the main reaction from the Christian community that I've gotten is that I need to stop talking about this since it's making the body of Jesus look bad. Listen, talking about it is not making the body of Jesus look bad. Tolerating it is making the body of Jesus look bad. Repent. Stop being complicit. Bring this sin into the light, as Scripture says. Have nothing to do with the fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them.
If you've seen what I see, that the grave is empty, then you know what I know. Anything is possible. If you've seen what I see, that the grave is empty, then you know what I know. Anything is possible.
Hi. Suicide rates are rising rapidly. So most Jesus followers should prepare ourselves for a more active role in preventing suicides. We are on the front line since pros rarely get involved until a foot soldier helps connect people in crisis with trained professionals. E94.org is a Christian ministry dedicated to equipping the church to prevent suicide through free training of foot soldiers to prevent suicide through training, consulting, and resources. Get equipped to give hope and help and confidently refer people to professional counselors. Learn more at e94.org. Thank you.